crazy people and inappropriate people aside, like, my God, I think that thing's like anything better than meeting someone who's just like nice and just is like, hey, I watch your videos. Cause it's so crazy. Yeah. Cause you don't really get to ever, I know YouTubers say this all the time. You don't get to see the people who watch your videos.
No.
Yeah. Cause when I see a video that gets like 300,000 views, I'm like, oh yeah, cool.
Mm. Yeah.
Cool. But then whenever.
Whenever you see 300 people in your panel. Up,
like that's crazy that 300 people in one room would want to meet me.
Yeah.
That like blows my mind. And then they're like, most of them are so fucking sweet. So nice.
Yeah.
And it's like, man, I can't help but just like, you want a hug? You want a hug?
It's also just feels so nice, especially when it's like a small convention as well, where it's like the ratio of like attendees to people who know you is like staggering.
And, and it's so hard to try to voice your gratitude without sounding like that typical corny YouTuber, but that's
I appreciate you guys so much.
You want a hug? Ask me, I'll give you one. Probably even if you're sweaty, I'll give you a fat hug.
Yeah. I will give you a hug too.
I just pressured Gon into saying that, and Gon has to do it now. Gon wasn't going to give you a hug until I said it first. Just wanted to make that clear.
I'm not going to give you a hug. I'm kidding.
You know, they're not ranked enough for Joey. Sorry.
Yeah, I have ranks.
Joey's ranked. Sorry.
But like, you know, that's like the other thing as well. Like, I don't want to like dwell on the whole like cosplay's consent thing, right? But like, I feel that-
You can ask me for a hug. I don't give a shit. Right,
but like, I feel that like now, like at least with me, my general rule of thumb is like, especially if it's of a female, right? Like, cause I know like dudes don't give a shit if I hug them, right? Cause it's like just a fucking-
Oh yeah, let me cup your dick.
Yeah. Let me hold your balls.
Don't do that. Please don't do that. That's a joke.
Your balls heavy, you'll tell. Okay. But like, I feel that like, because of the whole thing with, especially recently, cons have become a little bit more sensitive. Yeah. Like, at least my general rule of thumb is, if you're a female or you're not like a dude, comes up to me and like wants to take a photo, I always ask like, is it all right if I put my hand on your shoulder?
Yeah.
Or like, you know, or like I wait for them to be like, can I hug you?
Yeah, dude, I do that, but like sometimes I forget and then I'm like, fuck, I just did it without asking.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
I'm a horrible person. Like, fuck, are they gonna go online and say I fucking killed? Like,
it's only until the last AX where I like, physically I need to get into the habit of doing this.
Yeah, yeah. Same here. Like before I was just like trying to read the air.
Yeah.
But now I just straight up ask, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I used to just be like, I used to just be like, okay, I kind of get the vibe that you're okay with it. Like, that's just risky.
Yeah, because a lot of them are just like, of course you can. Like, why is that even a question? I'm like, no, you don't understand. I have to ask.
Because it's weird, right? Because now, because you know, when we started off, I don't think any YouTuber ever thinks they're gonna get, you know, any kind of attention or any kind of success. So you kind of come into it with like the small person mentality.
Yeah,
and sometimes you just gotta realize that you can't get away with that anymore.
Right.
You know, unfortunately, even though you still see yourself as that same person who started off doing like YouTube videos in your mom's basement or whatever.
I still feel like that.
I still feel like that now.
Yeah.
But you know, you gotta-
But the numbers don't lie, right?
You gotta adapt. Yeah. Eventually.
Mm. It's sad. I mean, I feel like I have to like, in some aspects, it makes you like be a better person, right?
Yeah.
In general, like I'm not an asshole because I'll get called out for it.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Which is good. But then also I feel like I have to make sure everything in my life is completely 100% no, there is no doubt in my mind, in anyone's mind that I'm totally like in the clear.
Yeah.
Whereas most people it's like, okay, 90%, 70%, I'm not an asshole. It's like, all right, that's enough, right? But you know, it's kind of, and also like, I feel as well when you meet fans, sometimes they're really nervous because obviously they don't know you. And I feel like they're more nervous to put their arm around you.
Yeah.
And so I feel like they're like waiting for you to take the lead.
Right.
Yeah, which is, you know, again, like it makes it harder because like I used to just be like, all right, I guess they seem like they want it. Like, or where they stand for the photo. Because sometimes, you know, they'll just literally just stand in position, like touching you basically.
Okay,
then we're gonna put their arm around. But yeah.
And I think that's like another good reason why you like-
Should ask, yeah. I need to get in the habit.
Some of them are like, oh yeah, of course. Like they weren't expecting
it. I mean, I'm sure I'll come out of this pandemic being like,
I'm sure the pandemic will change a lot of the behavior about what's allowed and everything.
A million
like that.
Hover hand photos.
Although I do love the hover hand photo. There's something about it, man.
The best part is when they ask for a hover hand photo, and I'm just like, you get it.
And whenever I get someone ask me like, can you do a hover hand? I'm like, I can one up that. Let's do a hover hug. But you're just like doing this, but you're not touching at all.
Yeah,
it's fucking great.
I wonder, will conventions, will everyone be required to wear a mask when they finally
have probably it? For like the first 2 years.
Yeah, I mean, that depends on when the conventions are going to open up.
Exactly.
True, like, true. I doubt that there will be any conventions open next year.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. I just don't think, the world-
Didn't they hold one in like fucking Idaho or some shit?
Yeah, but I mean-
Like in the middle of the pandemic.
Yeah, exactly. But you know, they got fucking slammed for that, right?
Yeah. Like, I don't think there'll be any big profile conventions happening till at least the second half of the year.
And
that's like,
and the whole e-conventions are like, get that out of here. Get that out. I don't want to do an e-convention. Are you kidding me? Let's say.
I mean, I did a couple of e-conventions this year.
Did you actually?
Yeah, yeah. I did one for AnimeCon South Africa.
I think I saw that.
I did like a pre-recorded interview for that.
Oh, sick.
And I'm like, I wanted to, the only reason why I wanted to do that was because when the pandemic is over, I really want to fucking go to South Africa.
That'd be sick.
So it's just like, it's just connection building. So it's like,
damn, Joey's just playing with five head here. Like,
yeah,
I don't know. Like, I can't get myself to like attend e-conventions. Because like attending e-conventions is like, it's kind of like the equivalent of when you're like watching a food video or something, and you're watching this like 3-star Michelin chef like produce this like gorgeous looking food, and then you're sitting there with like your combini meal. You're like, this is just as satisfying.
This is almost the same.
You know what I mean?
No, I completely get that.
You like tear open the paper salt, like, yes, I am gourmet.
My 3-star MSG.